please mukwante my baby. Scratch it with him mukwante, please mukwante. Check us with say please mukwante my baby. Scratch it with him mukwante, please mukwante. Check us with I say I'm just in the intention. Gomba Ian controller, Ian controller. Say, I touch it in Saint John. Go malengo man, Ian controller, Ian controller. Say everybody now, Ibambe,
Iba benta yako.
Say Ibambe,
Iba benta yako.
Asambe sobo la latitu. So amazing. Give it up for soul culture.
I don't want to put you on the spot, ne?
No, I'm on the spot with everyone today.
But we have five values.
Five, ne?
Yeah.
Not four.
Five.
Five.
Yes. And so they, I want us to basically
and they know them.
Say these values.
Yes.
So we will start with spirit of partnership.
And equity. Say it with us. And
equity.
And
integrity.
And
caring.
And together, let's do the last one. Excellence.
Indeed. And hence, the name of the awards is the Ziyagezana Excellence Awards. We are here today to publicly recognize and celebrate the achievements of our colleagues and peers who have excelled in each of their functional areas.
Hey, you know, Dandoz, you know, it was a good year.
Hey, it depends on where you are, ne?
It was a good year.
But overall, I think it was.
You know, but towards October.
Hey, October. October.
Hey, people were edgy.
They were edgy. Oh, but it was the H-E. An amber.
Amber, stamper, cliche,
There is no idibaling today. And for those who do not know what idibala is, it means collapse. So people nearly collapsed in October, but we somehow managed to get them back.
And guys, we really need to be grateful, you know. And I hope no one did idibala, ne? You're on a serious note. In the spirit of celebrating excellence and shining a bright light on people who are making positive, lasting contribution to the organization and in personal capacities or as teams, we will next view the Let's Celebrate presentation. And now let me mention to say, please, we would like to say thank you to those that submitted Let's Celebrate achievements.
Yeah.
We would now like to request Mr. Sipho Musai, our Honorable Acting Chief Executive, to come forward for his address. Can we please give him a round of applause?
Round of applause.
We can do better than that.
Flate.
Oi. Oh, thank you so much. Thank you so much. Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. Lutile choir high bina ere. Aspelela, shortest chairman, aspelela. Yeah. And you didn't sing along. I don't know under Tema Kimian, maybe you're Labina Basarati. Wema paga paga, where's this? Deputy Chair of the Board of Randwater, Ms. Masacha Mbonambi, members of the board that are here, the executive management of Randwater, all Randwater employees, ladies and gentlemen, once more, good morning. Program Director, I would first like to thank you, Program Directors. First, I'd like to thank you for your excellent facilitation of the program at this very important event on our calendar. You are setting the appropriate tone for an event of this nature, and your work today is most appreciated. Ladies and gentlemen, it's always an honor and a privilege to be part of Randwater Ziyagezana Excellence Awards proceedings. And this year, we celebrate the 16th event. A big round of applause. Since 2003, Randwater has met annually to celebrate those individuals, teams, and divisions that have gone the extra mile to make a difference for the people they work with, and in many ways, also the communities which Randwater serves. These individuals and divisions have demonstrated extraordinary leadership, professionalism, cooperation, and humility in the delivery of service to Randwater. They have made the consistent theme of the awards of Izandla Ziyagezana, meaning one hand washes the other, a way of life at the Randwater workplace. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, make no mistake, however, that we are working during difficult times. The landscape within which we now operate is one that is full of challenges. I hope you listened to the Chief Executive, myself, Acting Chief Executive, myself, and the Chief Financial Officer when we presented the 2017. Let's say, I'm serious. I hope you listened to myself when we presented the 2017-18 operational and financial results to you and the respective meetings that we arranged over the past few years. I will not repeat what was said in those meetings with regards to these challenges, except to say that it was important for you to understand where we currently at as an organization and the role you play in achieving our strategic goals and objectives. I urge you all to embrace Randwater's vision and mission with dedication and enthusiasm, because your work contributions ultimately benefit communities and society at large. Our government is faced with the urgency to deliver improved and effective services to our people. These, ladies and gentlemen, are difficult times. These are times where your integrity and your work ethic will count for much. Some state-owned enterprises are facing the harsh reality of poor financial performance and even more frightening possibilities of job losses through retrenchments. In the water sector, there is a great scrutiny over our operations and processes. I'm sure some of you have been following the deliberations at SCOPA, where our department is featuring dominantly, and from time to time, Randwater is mentioned in passing. For boards like Randwater, the adherence to legislation, oversight, and executive scrutiny will remain top of the agenda. As an organization, we are under pressure to adopt innovative approaches and solutions that will reduce spending while prioritizing and fast-tracking service delivery. These call for continuous modernization of many of Randwater's methods, processes, and infrastructure. This award ceremony should therefore not only be a time for celebration, but most importantly, a time for showcasing and sharing knowledge and experience amongst peers in Randwater's quest for excellence. I'm aware that methods of adjudication and planning processes have gone towards the preparation of today's event. I understand that there are a greater number of participation in these awards, and that is very encouraging. This year, we receive a phenomenal 712 nominations across all sites. In my view, although we could not award all 712 nominees, you still all winners. Round of applause, please. This number, it also points to the fact that the enthusiasm for participation has not weakened in spite of the stringent parameters within which the respective awards are placed. It confirms that innovative ideas and actions can and are beginning to be implemented for the betterment of Randwater. Behind each entry, there is the commitment of the individual or team concerned. People who saw or created an opportunity to make the difference. They are not people simply doing their jobs. They are people with vision who walk the extra mile and apply their sense of creativity and commitment to serve differently. These are the people who excelled and will be rewarded today. Ladies and gentlemen, before we begin the process of handing out the respective awards categories, I would like to use this opportunity to thank each and every person at Randwater for the contribution to the success of 2018 Ziyagezana Corporate Awards. No, seriously, why are you not clapping? It's beautiful, guys. There you are. My special thanks must go to the members of the various education adjudication panels who willingly spared their time to carry out this exercise. Thank you for your commitment to Randwater. On behalf of the board, I express our appreciation to all those who participated in the various award categories. As in doing so, they have readily indicated their commitment to excellence and to the success of Randwater. I congratulate the winners of various award categories, and I look forward to even stronger participation in the next year's awards. Finally, I would like to thank each and every one who has played a role in the organization of the award ceremony. After we've done, I'll see you at work. Thank you.
Let us put our hands together as we welcome Mr. Lufwadi Makibinyane to come upstage and do the honorable task of he knows.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is a pleasure for me to be standing here today as a veteran. You know, there is a veteran everywhere, in the board, in the executive, and a veteran, according to the Water Services Act, is somebody who can serve 3 terms, so which means a total of 12 years. So I'm entering that space of the last term as a board member of Randwater. I've been here since time immemorial. We have had the acting chief executive officer here saying 2009, he arrived here. So it was almost the same time that I arrived. I've actually grown a little bit older, as you can see, gray hair. And the gray hair I've received as a result of providing oversight in this organization. You know, that is what it does, you know. And, you know, I'm here to actually give apologies of our chairperson, Advocate Faith Hashate, who couldn't be here with us today. But you all know her very well, because she is as long as myself on this board. And we have said that because the new board has been appointed, it is important to know who are the guardians of this organization from the board side. And you understand governance, as Vincent has highlighted casually about the fiduciary duty of the board, providing resources and making you as happy as you are today. And if you want to understand the saying that the fish rots from the head, most organizations are not as privileged as this organization, purely because of dysfunctional boards. Very dysfunctional boards, who come to the boards not to discharge their fiduciary duty, but to look at their own interest. And you must be privileged that at least you had a cool-headed board over the last couple of years. And we can commit that we will continue to do our fiduciary duty and to hold the executive accountable, because they are not the law upon themselves. Everybody has got limits and limitations of power. They account to us, we account to the minister account to the portfolio committee of parliament, and so forth and so forth. So people must understand, and you, as you execute your job, that you don't have the carte blanche. There is always limitations of power. And if everyone in this country can recognize that, I'm sure we can go far, isn't it? So without further ado, because I thought that you have to know your board, this is the only occasion that we meet with almost 2/3 of this organization, of 3,400 workers. It's only this time that you are able to interact and see your board members. And as we reset the clock for the next 4-year term of the new appointed board, I will call upon them one by one, starting with the deputy chair, Masacha Mbonambi. Please come and join me on the floor. Followed by Ramateu Munyokolo. Ms. Sophie Mulukwane Machika, Ms. Nomsa Mbileni, Mr. Protas Pili, Mrs. Mankoni Ntaba. These are the new board members. And in our absence, as I said, is the deputy, is the chair, Faith Hashate, and Savannah Mazia. That constitute... Oh, yes, and what is his first name?
Ahmed
Pando.
And Mahlatse...
Mahlatse who? Gabi. Mahlatse Gabi. Yeah, so there are three other board members that are not here today. But those who are here, take note of them, recognize them, and appreciate the work that they do tirelessly, without sometimes getting recognition. Because as the board, unfortunately, we don't get bonuses. We discharge our job as giving to the nation. That has given so much to ourselves. You know, we do get our rewards somewhere else. But, you know, take note of those. And guys, I want to say that respect the work that is done behind the scenes by this board. Thank you very much. I think on that basis, I will leave here the deputy chair, who's going to deliver a keynote speech on your behalf. Program directors, I've done that one for you. Thank you very much.
A good morning to all of you. On behalf of the Board of Randwater, it is only befitting of me to extend an exceptionally warm welcome to everyone here today and to thank you all for finding time to be part of the proceedings of the day. It is indeed an honor for me to be talking to you on behalf of the board, this being our very first few months of the term of the current board. It has been an interesting time indeed, and we are grateful to those who have assisted us in ensuring that our onboarding was a seamless one. I would like to convey sincere apologies from the chairperson of the board of Randwater, Advocate Hashadze, who would have liked to have been with us today, but due to circumstances beyond her control, she could not make it. She sends her best wishes to all of you. Today's event is a special one, not only because we will be recognizing and cheering on those colleagues who have been exemplary in living the values of our organization in various categories of the 16th Ziyagezana Excellence Awards during the 2017-18 financial year. It is also because we are recognizing all of you, the employees of Randwater, for the contribution you make on a daily basis in the various roles that you play in this organization to ensure that you achieve the objectives. A round of applause for everyone. Water is a primary source of life. It is said that a big percentage of the human body is made of water. In fact, without water, human beings, animals, plants in general would not survive. In our country and many others around the world, access to clean water is a basic human right enshrined in the Constitution. This demonstrates the enormity of the responsibility and the importance of our organization and each and every one of you to our country. That is why today we are taking time to reflect and acknowledge all of your contributions, and especially that of our colleagues that will be awarded this Ziyagezana Awards. Ladies and gentlemen, leadership is about a shared vision, accountability, and responsibility. I want to assure you that during our tenure as the new board, we intend to continue building on the achievements and successes to date, taking our organization to new heights. We intend to cultivate excellence by celebrating it. This is how the best people will be retained and attracted to Randwater. However, in order to reach the apex, we have to rise above the expectations of our stakeholders, the communities who rely on us to provide clean potable water that others bottle, brand, and sell at a hefty price. Government, as one of our stakeholders, rightly expects us to be ahead of climate change and the dynamics of the water scarcity issues. We need to work smart, be proactive, and come up with appropriate and innovative response strategies that will help us that will keep us ahead of the curve in exploiting and preserving this scarce and essential resource. I therefore call on all of you to join me in frankly reflecting on the challenges of the past, the reflection that is to enable us to critically assess the present and to work towards a future with great enthusiasm and passion as we continue to intensify our strategic and operational efforts and contributions at all levels. The government landscape has changed over the past decade, but some things have remained the same. What has changed, which requires us to view and judge things differently, is the conduct of some executives and governance structures in other organizations, which has brought those organizations to the brink of bankruptcy in some instances. This requires the board as a collective working closely with management to heighten its governance oversight and lead ethically and effectively. We do not need to look abroad to identify instances of corporate governance failures. We have enough examples in our country to learn from. What we cannot afford to do is to assume that it cannot happen to an organization as good as and as strong as Randwater. That is why it is critical that as the board and management, all our decisions are based on what is in the best interest of Randwater, and that at all times we strive as far as possible to balance the interests of all stakeholders. What has not changed are those basic principles of integrity, competence, responsibility, accountability, fairness, and transparency. And if I can zoom into the principle of integrity, it is about acting in good faith, acting in the best interest of the organization, acting ethically beyond mere compliance and setting the right tone at the top. As the board, we are truly honored to be part of this remarkable organization that has performed so well over the past years, and we genuinely believe that success is achieved only through collective effort and teamwork. Therefore, I ask for your support and commitment into the future to ensure the realization of our vision, our goals, and our strategic objectives. It is, after all, about the survival of humanity. It was Marianne Wilson who, in her book, A Cause in Miracles, said, "Our deepest fear is not that we are inadequate. Our deepest fear is that we are powerful beyond measure. It is our light, not our darkness, that most frighten us. Your playing small does not serve the world. There is nothing enlightened about shrinking so that others won't feel insecure around you. We are all meant to shine as children do. It's not just in some of us, it is in everyone. And as we let our light shine, so people will let us shine." To our winners today, it is indeed a privilege for me to share in the formal recognition of your extraordinary contributions. It is through such efforts of excellence that we are able to ensure an organization delivers fully. To this end, I trust that you will continue to serve Randwater in the same manner and even better, which has now endowed you to this special public acknowledgement. To those who did not win this year, do not lose heart. Continue excelling in all you do. Your efforts do not go unnoticed. In closing, ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the board, I would like to take this opportunity to wish each and every one of you well over the festive season and an exciting new year. To those who will be taking some time off to recharge those batteries, do it responsibly. And to those who will be keeping the water flowing, keep up the good work. Enjoy the entertainment and all the festivities that have been especially prepared for you today. I thank you.
Now we're going to ask Ntate Makume to come upstage and do some connection to some processes. And give him a round of applause, Dr. Makume!
Alala, alala.
And you must see him. He's in it. He's looking great.
Oh, look at him.
Ah, Dr. Makume.
Yes, Dr. Makume.
Now, I thought I was at church. I said, I'm going to be a little bit. ladies and gentlemen, it became very difficult for me to keep quiet when Tandose was talking about attrition rates. I felt that there is a component. In spite of those people who left because of, what shall I call it, moral, ethical, disciplinary lapses, who left the organization. And of course, those people, unfortunately, who died untimely in Randwater service. There is a very important component of the people in this organization, and you have experienced for the past 10 years or so a lot of stability, number one, in terms of our board members who have been here for a very long time. Amongst them, Tate Makivinyan. Tate Makivinyan is my homeboy. And Dwale, Tate Makivinyan na sfuwa santwele sebeletsuka udimu, hakina so. Somebody where I was seated was talking about you. Mamure and Arno, when Ali and I, you belong to the same WhatsApp group. I don't know what she meant. So we have had stability in terms of our board, our executives, most of them have been with us for more than 10 years. And that has brought a lot of stability. Would like to take this opportunity to recognize, number one, our executives who have been here for more than 10 years. Can they kindly stand up, please? I'm instructing you upwards, but I'm allowed. Thank you, thank you, thank you. We have people in this organization who have been here for more than 10 years. And that is less than the average service of employees in Randwater. The numbers are so big that we cannot bring them forward to come and occupy the stage. Can those who, during the course of this year, achieved 10 years service, please stand up? And let's give them a round of applause. Yeah, there were many, a lot of them. Thank you very much. And we have amongst us those who have been here 2 decades, 20 years, 1 score. And there are those who have been here 30 years, my age. Can they kindly stand up, please? And we have those who are 40 years, is justice among them? Those who have been 40 years with the organization? Can they kindly stand up, please? I know we have them. Can we give them a round of applause? Ladies and gentlemen, we appreciate that there are employees in Randwater who are prepared to stay, who are not job hopping, who are staying, and they give us a lot of stability in terms of what they do. I was just disappointed when the choir gave us a rendition. You know, we as Africans, we like to attach our own words to music. Now, when I was growing up there, the guy was called Dollar Brent. He was singing a song called Manningberg, that's where it's happening. And we used to say, Makoti Karikipere. You don't play that song at a wedding. You don't play that song at a wedding. Now, if Riputile Matsoro Shebile Banava Seveza, yet we are supposed to be celebrating excellence. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
Greetings to our new board members and our PIC members that are here. As indicated by the program director, my name is Lefenya Botelo, and I do hail from a township called Pampierstad. Yes, I'm from Group Internal Audit, which is an independent and objective assurance provider within the organization. As indicated again earlier on, one of Redwater's strategic objectives is to achieve a high performance culture. And the Ziyagezana Excellence Awards is just one of those, is just one of the initiatives by the organization to enhance and promote this culture of high performance. Now, Group Internal Audit did not participate directly within this process of awards, but played a role of an observer within the adjudication process. Now, the observation process entailed the following. We observed the opening of the sealed envelopes that were received from all sides. And we observed, we verified the recording of all nominees. We also had an opportunity to sit down with the adjudication committee, and we verified that all sides were represented, including our unions. The other thing that we verified was that all committee members signed their confidentiality forms, and that anything that could hinder the process from being fair has been declared prior to the adjudication process commencing. And the other thing that we verified was that any member of the adjudication committee that needed to be recused for any specified category was recused timely. The other important thing that we need to mention was that because we received such a high number of nominations, we had to verify that all nominations or motivations received were considered, including those that were written in vernacular, or should I say isiZulu or and Afrikaans. With that said, based on the work performed, we can safely conclude by giving reasonable assurance that the Ziyagezana Excellence Awards adjudication process was fair, it was transparent, and it was objective. So with that said, well done to all the nominees and congratulations to all the winners. I'd like to echo the words of our Deputy Chair. Your contribution within the organization does not go unnoticed. Thank you.
For the moment we've all been waiting for.
Yes, yes.
Each award category will be announced by our very own talented employees from Randwater. The actual awards will be presented by our portfolio executives and board members.
And the first category we are awarding in today is the Employee of the Year Award. I would like to call on stage the first set of announcers, the gorgeous Miss Nompumelelo Moloi and the dashing Mr. Vishal Paima.
As supermodel Naomi Campbell would say, everyone is looking gone with the wind, fabulous. In awarding the Employee of the Year category, the nominated employee must have continuously lived all five values of Randwater: treating everybody with respect, giving outstanding customer service, being ethical at all times, must have portrayed a sense of caring for colleagues, customers, and the environment. And lastly, the individual must have illustrated a spirit of partnership towards achieving common work goals and building ongoing trust relationships.
The following seven nominations were received from our main sites for the Employee of the Year Award. Sesemana Makasane, Bad Water Distribution and Transport.
Samuel Sibanda, Combined Smaller Sites.
Crispin Mukaro, Reed Flay.
Cynthia Hatting, Vereniging.
Yakomi Eichen Hayes, Sege Bosch.
Aaron Matomba, Matiba, Swar Copies.
And lastly, Bonginkosi Mahlalela Mpumalanga.
And the winner is
Guess who's the winner? Samuel Sibanda, combined small size sides.
We are here to find out Hori, Boso Kimang. Musa, Boso Kimang.
What's your Musa? Kina.
And what makes you think that you're the boss? Because there are qualities. What qualities do you have?
I can be grumpy. I can call you to my office right now. Just.
No, Musa. We cannot say that in front of our bosses because our bosses are here. Let me tell you the qualities of a boss. He or she must have motivated staff by consistently drawing from the strength in the differences in the team. He or she must have illustrated effective management of resources, consistently recognized staff for exceptional performance, maintained a healthy team spirit, and also personally lived the values of Randwater.
And the following seven nominations were received for the Boss of the Year Award. Francine Nell, Bulk Water Distribution and Transport.
Jimmy Maluleke from Combined Smaller Sites.
Chokozani Boikuto, Reed Flay.
Shadrach Mukari from Firenacheng.
After Tulsi, Zeker Bosch.
Balungile Mathe from Swarkopis.
Floyd Matane. Let's look closer. I don't see anything.
And the winner is
Thokozani Boikutso, Replay.
Coming together is a beginning. Keeping together is progress. And working together is success. In awarding the Team of the Year category, the nominated team must have maintained a healthy team spirit whilst living the values of Randwater. The team must also have illustrated improved efficiencies for the financial year, exceeded customer expectations, and achieved exceptional performance by exceeding targets. The following nominations were received from our seven competing sides for the Team of the Year Award.
Civil Workshop Team.
Bulk Water Distribution and Transport.
The Chemistry Team.
Combined Smaller Sides.
The Bulk Sanitation Team.
Ridley Santin!
The Main Stores Team.
BG Vereniging.
Another Main Stores Team.
That is from Zeker Bosch.
The Akenhof Maintenance Team.
ZK Sarkopis.
And finally, the Electromechanical Team.
That is from Mpumalanga. That's great, in the heat.
<Drrr. laughs> the best performing team, and Randwater is...
What do you guys think? You sound clueless.
The winner is the chemistry team from combined smaller sites.
Lipstick Raymond Waning.
My name is Siyavuya Kalimashe.
And my name is Nhlapho Fanyani. Usikekete samavula samathola sinyawe sanhlele. Mthethe babagazi. Esikekete zivala ka makhanda amadoda emnyawo. Aw. Kathwa yidi bana lothi. Okay. In awarding in this category, the adjudication committee look at the best innovation in terms of cost savings, improved efficiencies, or creative value-adding idea that has been approved and implemented with success by the nominated team and or individual. The following five nominations were received from our main sites of Innovator of the Year Award. And the nominees are
Changelani Masingi
from Bulk Water Distribution and Transport,
Vidkowska
from Sekerbosch.
Gede, take us through whom takes the award.
Okay. The winner is
Fatima Kovadia
from Woodflame.
Hello, everybody. I've been asked to say a few words. This is very impromptu, and I wasn't prepared for this. This award means a lot to me, and it means a lot for everybody that works for Randwater. The award for the innovator is because I designed a GIS portal to bring Randwater up to speed with all the other companies that have their own portal. So portal is basically you can sit at your desktop and you can access all Randwater's infrastructure, Randwater's networks. You will be able to make decisions immediately. It's very interactive. It's very user-friendly. You can run queries on the pipelines. When I call people at the sites and the district inspectors and I set them up on the portal, they were very excited. I could actually feel people jumping in their chairs when they said, we can see our pipelines, we can see everything. And it was a lot of hard work. I worked a lot at home. I spent a lot of time developing it. I'm not a programmer, but I managed to do it, and for me it was an absolute achievement. It's the highlight of my career at Randwater. There is... There is so much more that I want to do with the portal. I want to link the reservoir level so every morning when you walk in, you can actually see the reservoir levels, and it's accessible to every single staff member at Randwater. So yeah, we're taking Randwater into the future. So thank you all for this. I really, really appreciate it.
My name is Tawe Siboza, and with me here is the lovely, the gorgeous, ngesilungu. Gorgeous, ngesiSwati. Gorgeous, kaSetswana. Fezile, aka Fezile Mafes. And we're from Randwater, Mpumalanga. Bakhona base Mpumalanga.
Yeah! Woo!
Yeah, that's our crew. That's our crew right there. And we are here to announce the mover and shaker of the year.
Ladies and gentlemen, in awarding in the mover and shaker category, the individual or team must have demonstrated exceptional performance and behavior that showed that this individual or team was a change agent for positive change at the workplace and built relationships based on mutual trust.
Yes, and the following four nominations were received from our main size for the Mover and Shaker of the Year Award. And the nominees are Sandi Swatasi from Bulk Water Distribution. Woo. Kuliso Nemalili from Combined Smaller Sites. Siyabonga Ngwenya from Vereeniging. Woo. And last but not least, Sipati Utlowa from Sekerbosch.
Yes. Ladies and gentlemen, we are about to announce the winner. Mm-hmm. If you are sitting next to our nominees, please make sure that they don't idibala. Ladies and gentlemen, and the winner is... And the winner is...
I'm taking my time.
And the winner is...
The winner is...
Kuliso Nemalili
from Combined Smaller Sites.
Hello, Randwaters. Are we okay today? So fabulous people in front of me. We all looking gorgeous.
In awarding the best wellness champion, the individual must have actively participated in all wellness projects and interventions, as well as displayed a genuine passion for wellness by being a role model to colleagues and peers. This individual must have also provided leadership on wellness interventions and created awareness as well as an understanding of the triple zero strategy.
Did I say it right? Strategy.
Strategy.
Strategy. Strategy. Yeah.
The following three nominations were received from our main sites for the Wellness Champion of the Year Award. The nominees go to
Palisa Mohanwe Bulk Water Distribution and Transport.
Ntifeleng Ntsawu from Vereeniging.
Matabo Koshela ZB, which is Ziyagezana.
And the time we've all been waiting for. Gumanu Mangwaba.
Yeah, who's that? Who's gonna be dancing there? Coming right here on this stage.
And
the winner.
The winner is
Matabo Koshela. Koshela.
All right, okay. I can't hear you. Good afternoon, Randwater. Ninjani. Siyaphila. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, angihambi ngiyedwa. I've got, he calls himself the commander. Like he bossed me to call him commander. MJ. Zitinda, Skipan. Where's your army?
Scientific.
MJ, what do you understand about a values champion?
Sick! Anna! I think I'm going to be a good one. I'm going to be a good one. Sick! I'm going to.
When you look at the value champion perspective, when I define it, it reminds me of Ditiro Petlele. When you talk about Ditiro Petlele, we are talking about somebody with integrity.
Aish.
We are talking about somebody who was caring for the organization as Randwater. The person who had the spirit of partnership in the sense that he managed to organize all the sides to have young professionals in terms of excellence. Mm. And the second person that I can talk about, you look at now in this country, we're talking about a 100-year celebration, Mama Albertina Sisulu.
Yes.
Mama Albertina Sisulu, she cared for this particular country. Mm. In 1956, when she took an initiative to go Pretoria, mm-hmm. when they were portraying Baisa Ilibo Me, what she played to say, I care for my country. And she had integrity from where she started until her death. And she had the spirit of partnership with Mme Lilian Ngoyi, Mme Helen Joseph, Abana Mme Sophie De Brainy. Then they pushed that particular thing. And Her Excellency, it was one, Hannah Anominator, Ndate Mandela to be the president of this country. So they were the value champions of this particular country. I thank you.
Well, Mr. Commander in Chief, I think maybe we should start calling you Pastor. but in awarding the values champion category, the individual must have been a role model to colleagues and peers. By consistently modeling the core values, displaying ethical behavior, fostering collaborative relationship across Randwater, the individual must have promoted the values and championed the Ziyagezana Awards. By encouraging colleagues and peers to participate on an ongoing basis, thereby creating a culture of public recognition. The following nominees were received from our main sites for the Values Champion of the Year.
Woo! Asizweke manje. Enoch Kanye.
From Bulk Water Distribution and Transport.
Eita James Mutseke.
Oh, kill comrade Lau.
Eita da.
From Combined Smaller Sites.
Eita da, siyavuya. Kalamashi, eita da.
From Perina Heng.
Yo, from America, Washington. Nguni.
Well, actually, he's from ZB, Seker Bosch.
Sick, washapa now. Mantua, Makofani.
From Swarkopis.
And the winner, ish, yeah, ne?
Drum roll, please. Drum roll, please.
Ah.
Drum roll, please.
Woo. Siya hamba tin.
Ebana.
Asa shapa vosho ga idivala ga America ga Washington. Nguni.
Damn.
Can we all give them a
round of applause for our announcers. They were really innovative, very creative. Round of applause, please, to Mr. Ricardo White.
When you walk through a storm, hold your head up high and don't be afraid of the dark. golden sky with a sweet silver song of a lark. Walk on through the wind, walk on through the rain, though your dreams be tossed and blown. Walk on, walk on with hope in your heart, and you'll never walk alone. You'll never walk alone. When you walk through a storm, hold your head up high. At the end of a storm, there's a golden sky with a sweet silver song of a lark. Walk on through the wind, walk on.
Gentlemen, we have come towards the end of the program. But of course, we have a way of ending things. And before we end them, we must invite. I remember when I hosted in 2016, we called her Diva.
The only one. Yes.
Yes, you know who I'm talking about, Akir.
I win.
I mean, what words can describe
exactly.
Miss Waida Muhammad?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, when you just look at her smile also.
Yes.
You cannot help but smile back.
Exactly. Or laugh.
Or laugh, actually. And she always comes being so beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
She exudes such beauty.
Wow.
And I will borrow again from what I said before, poise.
Mm-hmm.
And she's so confident.
Hey, bueno.
And I think she's the right person to do our vote of thanks.
Yes, man.
We are now inviting onto the stage Miss Waida Muhammad.
Round of applause!
Round of applause!
Okay. She comes in style.
things Randwater makes me do. What a beautiful energizer as I hit the podium. But as always, before I even get to the official bit of what I need to do, I want to just acknowledge every single one of you for turning out so beautifully today and for always giving so much love. Ndate Makume earlier on spoke about how long some members of staff have been at Randwater and asked for PIC members also to get up, and I was so stunned. I know I've heard it and I know that it's reached that point, but how time flies. But program directors, you look absolutely beautiful and you're doing an amazing job. And I think we've got some potential here for attrition, and I hope people won't be stealing our very bright employees, you know, in the media and other, you know, communication platforms, because I think these guys, it's like they've been trained for years to do this job. Won't you agree? Honorable Deputy Chairperson and the Board of Randwater, honorable board members present, our esteemed Acting Chief Executive, Mr. Sipho Maasai, and portfolio heads present today, my dear colleague, Ma'am Fikile, management of Randwater, employees, ladies and gentlemen. I know it's way in the day, but I'm going to greet you again, as is our African tradition, Sanibonani, Molweni, Dumelang, Rialocha, Dimashironi. Goeiemôre, goeiemiddag, good morning, assalamu alaikum, namaste. And a very good day to every single one of you here today. It's really always been and always will be a privilege for me to be associated with all of you, with Randwater. And it's been a privilege for me once again to be asked to do this vote of thanks on this beautiful and memorable occasion. I would like, with a grateful heart, to give thanks to our merciful Creator, our Father God, for waking us up, all of us, on this glorious day. We thank Him for the peace, the goodwill, the joy, the abundance mentality, and the celebration of today. I would also like, with a deep sense of appreciation, to acknowledge our members of the board who are present today. I begin by thanking you very much for making yourselves available in your very busy schedules to come and share with us in our joy and in this, the 16th Ziyagezana Excellence Awards. What you have witnessed today, for those of you who have just arrived, even new employees who have not experienced this before, what you've witnessed today is really the culmination of a very successful and well-organized trajectory spanning almost 16, 17 years. And this process, further to that, is also well-organized in terms of on-the-ground, iterative, from the ground up nominations and adjudication processes that could open themselves up to just about any scrutiny. Furthermore, as we bestow these awards this morning on individuals and teams, and as we noted their excellence, we also recognize the participation of many who have enthusiastically embraced this opportunity to identify and honor their talented and dedicated colleagues. The very same abundance mentality I referred to earlier on, I want to refer to again. Because if you can see the light in yourself, it's always possible to see the light in others. And if we struggle to see the light in ourselves, sometimes we struggle
to see the light in others. So that whole Ubuntu-esque consciousness is what we're asking to go back to and what Randwater tries to embrace in our small way. Umuntu, ngumuntu, ngabantu. To the winners, thank you for your invaluable contributions to the organization and for your unspoken commitment working towards achieving this vision for Randwater. And as both the deputy chair of the board as well as the chief executive shared with us, not many state-owned entities at this point are in a position to celebrate quite in the way that we do, simply because of the absence of that excellence. And so we continue to strive, albeit sometimes under very, very difficult circumstances. You know, complying with the AG sometimes isn't as easy as it seems, because sometimes I ask myself, they must send the AG staff on sabbaticals to work with us sometimes in the, and get sort of, you know, vuguzenzela mode and get down and dirty and get into the field and then perhaps get an appreciation. But at the same time, we appreciate the role that the AG plays in our country in terms of ensuring that there's oversight and scrutiny as far as public funds is concerned. I would like to thank the management of Randwater for heeding our call to encourage their staff to recognize and reward excellence in our organization. This proves once again that we are truly working together. And as you see us today in this auditorium, we are a very big, very dynamic, and very committed team. In terms of today's program, we have heard some very thought-provoking and inspiring words from both the acting chief executive and the deputy chairperson. We have always interacted at a level that allows for us to be able to engage and to share with each other, I suppose, our joys, our fears, as well as our achievements. So we've also viewed today very inspiring stories, presentations on individual team and organizational achievements. And I was really encouraged by the young lady, and her name escapes me now, my apologies, who received the Innovator of the Year award. She's not a programmer. Fatima. Fatima is not a programmer. But in her spare time, hardly any spare time available, I would imagine, she's busy working away, both at home and at work, for a solution, and comes up with a solution. And that's the kind of mentality that we want to encourage in Randwater today and going forward. And we've got many shining stars like Fatima, many. Some unsung, some hidden behind, you know, on the shop floor. But wherever you are, please know that your contribution, no matter how small you may think it is huge to be able to fuel this huge organization and to support the chief executive to be able to drive its vision forward. In that light and in the spirit of acknowledgement, let me begin by thanking again our board members for honoring us with your presence and for graciously presenting the awards. You look very beautiful today. Our acting chief executive, wow, he's looking every bit the ultimate gentleman, dashing, charming. And there's a brain behind that, fortunately. Thank you very much. To our portfolio heads, and today we've got my colleague Fix, as I call her fondly, representing the portfolio heads together with myself as well as Mr. Kubeka. And if you notice his dancing shoes, he came ready to get down. Beautiful shoes, Mr. Kubeka. And then as well, to everybody else across Randwater for allowing the chief executive, allowing the board members, allowing the PIC members to exist and to provide continued guidance. To the chief executive, your leadership, we thank you for, and also for creating an environment which is supportive, and we are publicly recognizing that excellence. Our MCs, I hope I didn't say too much earlier so that I have something left to say now. Your creativity makes you even more radiant. So, Ms. Ntandose Gamede, you're looking very beautiful. And also, Mr. Vincent Mellow, handsome and animated. Thank you for your impressive and excellent execution in directing the program for today. Oh, the announcers. I mean, don't you think the announcers were so well turned out? I kept saying, Randwater has such beautiful women. But then I should have added such dashing and handsome men. And I do have a healthy appreciation for that kind of dashing, you know? Also, your individual creativity as a group and your creativity coming up here as couples really made us feel this is an event worthy for a king. It could have been televised live at any of the channels. You did an amazing job, and from me as Maruna, put it on your CV. The various adjudication committees, inclusive, of course, of our very, very important stakeholder. I saw Mamurena today. I didn't see the other members from Labour, but I'm sure you are there. Thank you. You are our important, worthy stakeholder, representative of our beautiful employees. Thank you for being here today. Values champions, I'm sure you would have been pleased to hear that Mr. Mello, in the beginning, reminded us of the values of Randwater. And we would all do well by trying to remember that as we go about our daily business, especially through the trying times, the values of caring in particular, the value of excellence, naturally. Our supervisors, management, and our conveners in managing the adjudication and nomination process with integrity, kindness, and fairness. Internal audit, for the very important role that you play in overseeing that the adjudication processes are always free and fair and transparent. And maybe we should post you guys off to the forthcoming elections in 2019 to ensure transparency and fairness. Our nominators, you have an abundance mentality. Anybody that can find it within themselves to take a piece of paper or get onto their laptop or their computer and start writing something beautiful about another person that has the potential to promote them, has the potential to uplift them, in my view, is incredibly abundant. So without people who painstakingly, caringly, lovingly nominate their colleagues, without you, I want to tell you, we would not have been able to acknowledge the winners today. So thank you very much. You know who you are. Ah, the corporate choir, weren't they just to die for today? I've been asked if they have recorded a CD, and maybe it's something in Tate Makume and Z, and maybe something we need to think about. You're looking beautiful. You sang beautifully. Your spirit was present. We felt it. You acknowledge the outgoing CE. You acknowledge the incoming CE. Thank you very much for that. And also, if I can take this opportunity to thank Mr. Ricardo White. You did very well. And you know, by day, colleagues, he's an engineer. He's an engineer. So just in case you think people are engineers and scientists, they can't sing, I've got news for you. He's an engineer and he did a good job. Thank you so much, Ricardo. You also sang very beautifully for us last year. You are one of our Randwater singing sensations, and maybe we can start testing our voices to see whether, you know, we can resonate and also present our talent at the next Ziyagezana Awards. But your voices, all of you, the choir, Ricardo, and everybody else who's happy enough to sing along, your voices will resonate in our hearts forever. The service providers, the staff at NASREC, all of you in the back there, I can see you thinking, but this lady is going on and on, we're ready to serve the food. You're looking very good in your black and white attire, and thank you very much for serving us today. As well as the caterers, the technicians, and so on. An event of this dimension cannot happen overnight. It requires meticulous planning and an eye for detail in execution. I cannot thank everyone enough for your involvement today, because you've shown the willingness for that acumen to express itself in the completion of tasks beyond comfort zones. Hence, I would also like finally to recognize in particular Mr. Begi Buthelezi and his team for our beautiful flowers, for the decor, and for the draping. The procurement division, thank you guys, you made it happen. The purchase orders and stuff, at least they came through. Thank you very much. I hope you did the proper stuff in terms of the National Treasury prescripts, hey, the practice notes, okay? Otherwise, you know, GHRE may not stand here in future if the practice notes aren't correctly implemented and applied. Group Secretariat, thank you very much, and thank you for taking care of our board. The printing department and the main coordinating task team, we are most grateful to all of them for their passion. They run across portfolios. Thank you for your dedication and creative expertise. Ntate Saki Makume, Mr. Lawrence Mpehwane, Ms. Zinat Abdul Aziz, Mr. Itsokeng Mekhu, Mr. Arthur Shunyane, Ms. Lisa Fortain, Ms. Lungile Karoli, and our site communications officers. Last but not least, I would like to place on record our hearty thanks to every single one of you here today. Thank you for breathing in the same oxygen, for making this a wonderful and rewarding day. On behalf of Randwater and the Randwater Board in particular, who's graced us with their presence, management, best wishes to all of you for the festive season. And be safe, be happy, and have a blessed new year. Thank you. Ngiyabonga kakhulu, bayedankie.